Is your real estate market too expensive? The answer to that is yes, it is. Yes, I said it here for the first time. The real estate market in your market is probably too expensive, if I knew exactly what market that was, by the way. And despite the fact that your market may be too expensive, if you listen to the rest of this video, you will still learn how to make money in your market, because a market can be overpriced. So when you guys start saying, is the price of the property too expensive? Let's say a deal is $100,000. Let's say in 2018, this asset was 100 grand and it was a 5 cap, okay? And it paid $5,000. If it was $1 million, it would pay $50,000, right? So if it was $1 million, just to keep this simple, if it was a 5 cap, the cap would stay the same, but the price would change because it's more units or whatever, okay? And this would pay $50,000. If this deal was $10 million, okay, and it was a 5 cap, it would pay $500,000. $500,000, assuming in every situation that I paid cash for that asset, the cap rate determines what percentage I get if I pay cash for the asset. Let's say this was Arizona, Austin, or Fort Lauderdale. In 2018, you could have bought a $100,000 unit, you could have bought $1 million apartment deal, maybe a couple of fourplexes, or a $10 million, it was a 100-unit deal. If it was a 5 cap, it was a 5 cap. And I said 3 years ago, these cap rates will go down. At the same time, people were saying cap rates cannot go down. It is impossible for them to go down. And yes, sure enough, cap rates went down. What's the point of this? Is real estate too expensive? Was it too expensive then? Only to the people that were in the market, okay? You wanna pay attention to this. People in the market rarely change the market. Typically, it's a guy coming in to Arizona. Let's say this was Phoenix, Arizona, Chandler, Mesa, Scottsdale. I've been shopping all those markets. And people in Los Angeles moved over to Arizona and said, I'm gonna buy right here in Arizona. I'm gonna buy a $100,000 unit. I'm gonna get a 5% return. This thing is ridiculous, because they were looking in Los Angeles. Let's move to LA. That $100,000 unit, by the way, is $400,000. It still had a 5% return. So if I paid cash for this, I'd earn $20,000, $1,800 a month. And you're like, man, is that a good return? Oh, it's about 300 times better than the bank. The bank's not paying anything. But let me show you what happened here. This guy takes his $400,000 unit, sells it in Los Angeles, and moves his money to Arizona to get the same 5% return. But what does he buy? He can buy four of these, not one of these. And he thinks Arizona's cheap, where the people in Arizona are sitting there saying, oh, it's too expensive to buy here, okay? Don't worry about what things sold for last time. Worry about the return you get. This is not a house. A house is not a home. And a house is not an apartment deal. Houses do not produce cash flow. That's why I hate houses. If you're on the come up and you're trying to create wealth, you don't want a house, you want income from property. If you can buy a house, rent it to somebody else and get income, cool. But the problem with that is it's one door. And if it's one door, what do I say? Don't be a one door. You know what it is, okay? Fill in the blank. Post it below if you know what it means to not be a one door blank, okay? Why? Because when Janet moves out, you are now responsible for the mortgage, the property taxes, the fixies, and all the costs, okay?